In practice level 2 video number 30, its second video on instrumental variable regression. In the first video we have introduced instrumental variable regression for single endogenous regressor and single instrument. Here we have multiple endogenous regressors, multiple instruments, and at the same time exogenous regressors. If you recall, if X, your regressor, is uncorrelated with U, it's exogenous. If it is correlated with error term, it's endogenous. So we have here four type of variables: X variables, which are your endogenous regressors; W variables, which are your exogenous regressors; Z variables, Z variables, which are your instrumental variables; and Y is your dependent variable. Higher the value of R square in the first stage, it means you have more variation in X hat. So terminology, we have basically two words we are going to use: identification, over identification, under identification. So instrumental variable, if you have M number of instrumental variables, K number of regressors, now three situations arise. First, if number of endogenous regressors is equal to number of instruments, M are number of instruments, K are number of endogenous regressors. If both are equal, it's exactly identified, not an issue. If M is greater than K, number of instruments, you have more instruments than number of endogenous regressors, it's over identified, but not a big issue. We'll see in a short while. Third stage, if M is less than K, then it's basically it's an under identified model, then you have estimation issues as well. So you see, we have four type of variables. This is your dependent variable, these are your endogenous regressors, these are your exogenous regressors, and we have Z as instrumental variables. So you have four type of variables, and you have three situations: exactly identified, over identified, under identified. So what is the first stage in this case? If you have single endogenous regressor, and let's say you have M instruments and you have exogenous regressors, so regress this X on all Z's, on all W's, and get X hat. Use this X hat here and regress second stage. That will serve the purpose. To get standard errors correctly, you need to do it in one step instead of first stage and second stage. So I'll explain it in a short while with the help of stata. So log of quantity of cigarette, price, and we know that price is basically, it's not only price which affects cigarette demand, it's income as well. So here, if general sales tax, as we have seen in the previous video, general sales tax may be a proxy, or you can say is an instrument. But if your income is there, the general sales tax and income among provinces, among states, may be correlated. So in that case, whether to use this one or you should use cigarette specific tax as an instrument. So you see here, you have one endogenous regressor, K is 1, but you have two instruments here. Which instrument to use, which is weak instrument, which is strong instrument, I'll explain it in my next video. So let's go, we have two instruments here. Instead of going discussing here, I am going to show it with the help of stata. I'll discuss it in detail when I'll do a workshop. So we have constructed these so many variables before we process it. You can download this file directly from Stock and Watson website student resources. At the moment, I am going to run only two equations. One is regress This was the previous video regression. Regress. This is the first stage. No. Second stage. Okay. Fine. Now you can see we can have this equation, instrumental variable regression, by using average price on sales tax. Here you have single instrument. Here you have single instrument. I'll show you results as well. And here again you have single instrument, but you are using log of price per capita income as well. Here you are, you have again, you are using single regression, IVREG, LPSCK, PC, LR, AVG, PRS. I shall show all this in detail when I'll complete this topic and I'll conduct a workshop. So this variable is not defined text, so variable name is not correct here. So this one, but now we are going to include another variable here, log of price per capita, ln. Here I have this variable, ln per capita income. Sorry, per capita income. Now this sales tax may be correlated with this one, so we consider an alternative. Why this R at the end? For robust standard errors. Now you see, you have low income elasticity, high price elasticity. And now I am going to use two instruments. What is my other instrument? My other instrument is cigarette specific tax. So I am going to run this regression. Now I have here cigarette specific tax as well, because the first one, this may be correlated with log of per capita income. I'll demonstrate in detail in workshop. So you see here again, you have high price elasticity, but income elasticity is not very high. This is what we have been discussing in these slides. And now you can see here you have instrumental variable, and we get this -1.14 and all this, and we can do it in a single step. So instrumental variable regression, you have more instruments than number of endogenous regressors, and we can run it in this way. Which one is stronger, which one is weaker, that's a topic for our next coming videos. And this is stage by stage. We don't need to go by stage by stage. Okay, what are the instrumental assumptions? First is exogeneity, relevance, and there should not be multicollinearity among W's. I have a video on concept of multicollinearity. You can watch that. Okay, so expected value of U given W should be equal to 0. In OLS, we used to say expected value of U given X equal to 0. If this assumption, then W's are exogenous regressors. Y, X, W, these are IID. This is our usual assumption throughout the course. And there are no large outliers, that is finite fourth moment, that was also our usual assumption. And an additional assumption that these are valid instruments and relevant instruments. If these assumptions are satisfied, our standard statistical inference will hold and we can run our results. We can have confidence interval and testing as usual. So our next topic will be how to test instrumental variability, what is the criteria for strong instruments, weak instruments, how to go for methods other than two-stage least square when you have under-identification, and all these issues we'll discuss it in our next video. Thank you for watching. Take care.